Welcome back to Peer Guided DBT Lessons, provided by DBT Skills Application, Peers Helping Peers. This week's lesson, Mark 3-4 in our Emotion Regulation module, we'll be examining myths about emotion. Please keep in mind that we're simply peers helping peers, working together to bring about more peaceful, constructive, and ultimately happier lives. In other words, a life worth living. Sometimes what we believe about our emotions produces increased reactivity and extreme emotion. Emotions are complex patterned reactions to events that come and go, like waves in the ocean. What we think about our emotions can decrease their intensity or increase and prolong it. When you're experiencing emotions like anxiety, rejection, or despair, it's important to be aware of any of your own beliefs that may be making the experience of those emotions worse. What you believe and what you tell yourself about what you feel has a significant impact on the types and intensity of emotions you experience. There are certain myths that are more likely to leave you in anger, sadness, or anxiety. What messages have you received throughout life about your emotions and feelings? This is a very important question to consider because whether you are young, old, a man, or a woman, the media, your family, and society at large impart subtle yet powerful messages about how you are supposed to express, perceive, and deal with emotions and feelings. Do any of these sound familiar? Boys don't cry. The media clipped this scene out of the Superman movie to ensure boys don't get a message that it's okay for boys to cry. When the Superman movie came out in the theaters, it showed a powerful lesson with the image of Superman crying when Lois Lane died. I remember thinking, what a great message to boys, young and old, and to girls, that the stereotyping making crying a taboo subject was turned into something worthy of respect. Then, several years later, when the same movie was shown on network TV, that very powerful emotional part was simply clipped away as unworthy, once again confirming it's not okay to cry. Does terms like get over it and suck it up, girls don't get angry, you're such a sensitive girl, don't you raise your voice at me, more likely than not, these themes have drifted into your unconscious and may be impacting how you process your feelings, whether you realize it or not. Emotions are natural responses based on what we believe and think. And we can learn to accept how we feel and express these feelings in a healthy way. Developing emotional awareness, working through myths that may pervade your belief system, and validating our feelings is how we can start to deal with difficult emotions and begin cultivating greater positivity. Myth 1. There is a right way to feel in every situation. A range of emotions may be felt by different people as a response to the same event. Likewise, the intensity of the emotion and the physiological experience may also differ from one person to another. This is because we all have different physiologies, different accumulated life experiences, and different beliefs about ourselves, others, and how the world works. Fact. Emotions are not right or wrong, good or bad. All emotional experiences are valid. Emotions provide us with cues and clues about specific situations and prepare us to respond. There are individual differences on how we experience emotions. It is the accompanying behavioral response that can give a situation a constructive or non-constructive resolution. Myth 2. Letting others know I'm feeling bad is a weakness. It's likely some of you came from a family background that didn't openly express emotions. Yelling was not tolerated and crying was a clandestine activity. Because of this, you may have learned that expressing emotions isn't appropriate and shows that you just can't handle what life has to offer. We can all put on this emotional armor at times, but when we never open up and intimately connect with others, relationships will suffer. If we have come to believe that expressing emotions is a weakness, we'll have trouble coming to grips with our true self. We'll lack congruence and always be hiding behind a mask and facade of how we truly feel and who we truly are. Fact: we all experience unpleasant emotions, not because we are weak, but because brains are geared to be informed by emotion. Acknowledging and expressing them appropriately, even if just to ourselves, can put us in a significantly improved position to take effective action and move our lives forward. Myth 3. Sometimes emotions just come out of the blue and can happen for no reason. Even though we are not always aware of the causes, there tends to be specific triggers, situation, people, thoughts, that lead us to react a certain way. Emotions come on very quickly, but they do stem from somewhere, most likely from our beliefs or the way we think about a certain situation. When we don't have conscious awareness about what triggers our emotions or how to perceive and notice what emotion we are experiencing, it can seem like emotions come out of nowhere. Fact. However, when we can learn to be aware of the triggers in our environment, the body changes that occur, and what we are thinking about, we can develop the skill of emotional intelligence and begin to think about our feelings instead of acting on them. Myth 4. Negative emotion is bad and destructive. Fact. Emotions are neither positive nor negative. They are there for a reason. They may be more or less pleasant or comfortable, but they are not bad or bad for us. It's what we do in response to our emotion that makes the difference. Emotions such as anger and sadness are there for our survival and learning to recognize when these emotions are constructive and destructive is the key. For instance, sadness helps us grieve loss and gain social support and bond with others through the process. However, when grief and sadness leads to depression, we might have a problem. Emotions are there to help us navigate life as long as we don't let them overtake us. It's what we do in response to our emotion that makes the difference. Myth 5. I feel it, so it must be true. Sometimes emotions feel so strong or overwhelming that you believe they must be true. If you feel helpless, it doesn't necessarily follow that you are helpless. If you feel anxious, it doesn't always mean that you are in danger. Fact: emotions reflect thoughts, and if your thoughts are inaccurate or misguided, your emotions may be too. Myth 6. I know exactly what you did to upset me. People are often mistaken about their own emotions. They misread and misname them. Fact: And of course, they misread other people's emotions, particularly when their perception is colored by their own preferences or prejudices. Consider the emotionally complex situation of divorce. Experts note that husbands' reactions are often dominated by anger, an emotion that allows them to maintain a confident and dominant position. A therapeutic goal is to help men recognize that some of their negative effect may come from sadness, hurt feelings, and fear, emotions that are more painful and scary, and that they may be motivated to avoid. Media has given the message that these feelings are not as acceptable. Misattributions usually disappear when people are made aware of the true source of their affective states. Myth 7. I should feel differently. The ultimate shame-producing mentality. Thinking we should feel a certain way when we don't, or be a certain type of person when we're not, is exactly the type of perspective that leads to shame and self-criticism. How we think we should be is based on comparing ourselves to others and all the external expectations we have been inculcated with since we were young. This sets us up for failure to be something we're not. Fact. Even though you do have some control over your emotions, your feelings aren't wrong. But people often say things like, "I know I shouldn't be so upset over something so little," or "I really should be happier than I am." Rather than waste energy beating yourself up over how you feel, accept that you feel that particular emotion right now and recognize that you have choices in how you react to it. Myth 8. If others do not agree with how I feel, then I must be wrong. There is no right or wrong emotion, so emotions cannot be judged. If you feel a certain way, then it is what you are feeling, regardless of what others say. Fact. People can experience different emotions after the same event. There is no clear-cut, normal way to feel in any situation. Your emotional reaction is what it is, yours. Learning skills to non-judgmentally observe, accept, and work with our emotional experience is an important set of skills to support a happy, healthy, and meaningful life. Myth 9. Other people are the best judge of how I feel. If there's one thing you know more about than anyone else, it's you. Basing the way we feel on the judgments of others makes emotional awareness very difficult. We are always the best judge of how we feel and what is going on in our body and soul. If something doesn't feel right, there is probably a reason for this. Fact. Learning to trust our intuition and judgments is crucial to reaching peace of mind. It may take practice, but we are the best suited person to make decisions for our life. Don't ever tell anyone or let anyone else tell you, "I know how you feel." No one can know how we truly feel except ourselves. Myth 10. Being emotional means being out of control. I imagine there are times where you have lost your temper or did something you regretted based on a moment of passionate emotion. It happens to the best of us. It can be very hard to control anger when we're in the middle of it. But there are strategies that can help us more effectively manage our anger and respectfully communicate our anger to others. It just takes practice and motivation to change. Being in touch with our emotions doesn't equate with being out of control. We can be very in control and learn to use reason and logic alongside emotion and feelings. Fact. Learning to experience our emotions in an objective manner provides a way to think before we act, while still acknowledging the way we feel. Myth 11. Painful emotions should be ignored and repressed. Some emotions can feel uncomfortable or painful. As humans, we try to do everything we can to reduce emotional pain, such as ignoring or dismissing our emotions. Ignoring our emotions will not make them go away and could lead to damaging effects on our overall happiness and functioning. Painful emotions are especially important because they leave significant emotional scars that need to be healed. When we don't pay attention to the way we feel and try to block out our emotions, it only comes back to bite us in the end. When painful emotions and feelings emerge, we can learn that ignoring them helps us avoid conflict and further stress, but this is a paradox that will ultimately prevent us from ever solving any problems and dealing with what we are avoiding. Fact: getting in touch with our feelings means becoming vulnerable enough to connect with all our emotions. Myth 12. Other people have the power to make me feel certain emotions. We tend to assume that others make us feel a particular emotion. For example, she made me angry. To a small degree, this is true. People and events cause us to feel all the time and trigger emotional reactions deep within our brain and nervous system. We can, however, learn to modulate and regulate our emotions so that we can turn them up or down a bit, like a dimmer switch. Fact: clearly, others can influence your feelings, but they can't control them. It's up to you to be in charge of the way you think, feel, and behave. Myth 13. I can't handle uncomfortable emotions. Doubting your ability to deal with uncomfortable emotions, like anxiety or sadness, can lead to avoidance. And the more you avoid discomfort, the less confidence you'll have in your ability to deal with hardship. When someone feels anger, they may experience a strong urge to yell, fight, and damage property, but this doesn't mean that they will do these things. They can learn to be informed by anger and use this to guide effective action. Likewise, when someone is experiencing deep sadness, it may feel like the sadness is going to crush them. Or when they are very anxious, they may believe that they are going to come to some harm. Even though emotion feels overwhelming, emotion will not cause us any physical harm. Struggling against emotion, on the other hand, can cause harm. Fact: although some emotions are uncomfortable, they're tolerable. Allowing yourself to experience those emotions can be part of healing, and they can be the key to creating the best life for yourself. Myth 14. Controlling my emotions means behaving like a robot. Regulating your emotions isn't the same as suppressing them. Fact: you're capable of experiencing a wide range of emotions, but you don't have to be controlled by them. Emotion regulation is a skill that can help you build mental strength. The more you learn about how to cope with your feelings in a healthy way, the better equipped you'll be to heal from emotional pain, turn your feelings into productive action, and make the best choices for yourself. Myth 15. We should always act on our feelings. Feelings give us clues about how we might want to act, so it is a good idea to listen to them when making decisions. Fact: it is also important, though, to think through possible consequences rather than relying solely on your gut feelings. A simple example of acting on feelings is venting. Venting about your bad day or your mean boss won't make you feel better. In fact, research shows the opposite is true. talking about all the things that contribute to your emotional state as fuel to the fire. So don't call your friends to complain. Acknowledge your emotions, label your feelings, and move on if you want to feel better. Myth 16, the hydraulic metaphor. As the name suggests, if emotions are denied expressions, they will leak somewhere else, and we need to express our emotions to feel better. For example, we often talk about anger in terms of heating up, simmering, or boiling over. Fact: the metaphor represents passivity, against the view that emotions can be cultivated and educated. Research in emotion regulation has shown that there are a variety of ways that inappropriate emotional reactions and experiences can be disrupted by making use of our human ability, reinterpretation and distraction. For example, we often use humor to block anger or fear to resolve tension. Myth 17. Being angry with others is wrong. Fact: anger is a natural emotion and not a sign of bad morals. Feeling angry is never wrong. What can be inappropriate is the way anger is outwardly expressed. It can be very hard to control anger when we're in the middle of it, but there are strategies that can help us more effectively manage our anger and respectfully communicate our anger to others. It just takes practice and motivation to change. Myth 18. Negative emotions only happen to negative people. It is considered healthy to be able to experience a full spectrum of emotions, positive and negative. Fact: negative emotions like sadness, anger, and fear are universal and are experienced by all healthy individuals, not just negative people. Myth 19. I will always feel this way. Fact: emotions are essentially transient. A typical emotional response involves a quick rise lasting for a few minutes, followed by a relatively slow decay. For example, anger usually lasts for more than a few minutes, but rarely more than a few hours. However, people tend to mispredict the short duration of emotional response. For example, after a romantic breakup, heartbroken people are unable to anticipate the decay of their emotions. One of the reasons for adolescents' high risk for suicide is because when they feel pain, they lack the life experience to know it is temporary. After a while, the change becomes a normal and stable situation. Myth 20. We should be able to snap out of our emotions whenever needed. Fact: emotions are complex and involve changes to our body chemistry and mental state. Expecting ourselves to be able to just switch feelings off would be unrealistic. But moods can be reversed. A variety of studies have demonstrated that adopting facial expressions of emotion can lead to the corresponding emotional feelings. In other words, fake it till you make it. An expression of pride produces determination. Projecting pride motivates people to try harder in problem solving. If we force ourselves to relax our face and soften our voice, our internal state will soon come to resemble our external state. We can learn to move past these myths we have held on to since our childhood. We can heal as a person and learn how to effectively deal with emotions and the distress that may accompany them. This comes from learning that mistakes are okay, being willing to accept ourselves and how we feel, being vulnerable enough to share these feelings, and knowing that we are not our feelings and we don't have to act upon them. Be free from these myths and find peace of mind. And finally, in recapping, myth 1. There is a right way to feel in every situation. Myth 2. Letting others know I am feeling bad is a weakness. Myth 3. Sometimes emotions just come out of the blue and can happen for no reason. Myth 4. Negative emotion is bad and destructive. Myth 5. I feel it, so it must be true. Myth 6. I know exactly what you did to upset me. Myth 7. I should feel differently. Myth 8. If others do not agree with how I feel, then I must be wrong. Myth 9. Other people are the best judge of how I feel. Myth 10. Being emotional means being out of control. Myth 11. Painful emotions should be ignored and repressed. Myth 12. Other people have the power to make me feel certain emotions. Myth 13. I can't handle uncomfortable emotions. Myth 14. Controlling my emotions means behaving like a robot. Myth 15. We should always act on our feelings. Myth 16. The hydraulic metaphor. Myth 17. Being angry with others is wrong. Myth 18. Negative emotions only happen to negative people. Myth 19. I will always feel this way. And myth 20. We should be able to snap out of our emotions whenever needed. Next week in our peer-guided DBT Lessons Emotion Regulation module, we'll be examining body responses to emotions.